Operations research and analytics are all about making better decisions to manage a system using data. So you can divide it into kind of three steps or three different types of analytics. The first is descriptive analytics, which is basically trying to gather as much data as we can and make sense of the data, understand what data about the past and the present behavior of the system are telling us. The second type of analytics, or maybe the second step, you can think of as predictive analytics. So once we understand something about the system behavior, we want to try to make estimates or statements or forecasts about the future behavior of the system. And then the third type of analytics is what's been traditionally called operations research, but is also sometimes called prescriptive analytics, and that means that we're trying to not just understand the system but make it better. And so that's where tools like optimization and simulation and decision making come in. So some current projects that are important in the department right now, there are a couple different groups working on different aspects of plant breeding. So there's a lot of variables that are involved in choosing different breeds of plants that'll thrive in different environments. There are groups working on applying machine learning and optimization to different aspects of that problem so that the seed manufacturers can make the seeds that produce the most crop in different locations. Another area of interest that we have a few projects on is, broadly speaking, energy system optimization. And so that can be short-term scheduling, it can be long-term planning. And especially with the large amount of wind power in Iowa, we need to figure out how to manage the other parts of the system to sort of accommodate that uncertainty and the variability from day to day of the wind. So I think that the career opportunities in operations research and analytics are, some of the titles are data scientist, decision scientist, data engineer. Our graduates combine all three of those steps of analytics, the descriptive, the predictive, and the prescriptive, that I think make them really valuable to a lot of different types of organizations. So they may end up in manufacturing, in transportation, in financial services, healthcare. There's pretty much any place that you can find a large data set and a complicated system need the kind of person that we're training.